just ready to go today.
Everybody, I was really tired and then I took a little energy drink, so let's party. What's up? My name's Chelsea. If I am a new face to any of you, first and foremost, there is still a mask ordinance in effect in the state of Colorado. If you feel that it is unsafe for you to practice with your mask on, or you have a medical condition, only you can exempt yourself from that, but please only within the four corners of your mat space. If you step off of your mat for any reason, even while the rest of the studio is closed, make sure that you put that back on. And under that exemption, I will not be wearing a mask while I teach. Fun stuff out of the way. Weight safety. Weights are always completely optional in Sculpt. If at any point you are just like, this is too much for me this morning, no big deal. You can drop your weights. You will still get a great workout, I promise. Just kind of like mock as if you had the weights in your hands as you go through the movements if you choose to drop them. But if you do have them in your hands, a few things to keep your body safe as we move through a practice. Anytime you extend out from mid-body, keep a micro bend in your elbows and a light grip on your weights. I like to actually physically flare my fingers out to make sure I'm not death gripping them. This will just ensure that your muscles are actually doing the work and that you're not locking out through your joints along the way. Also, when we transition, come in through center, always press up, vice versa, to come back out. Just no swinging or windmilling action like we do in a typical vinyasa flow through our plank. And then speaking of plank, there will be a few times where we can keep the weights in our hands in this position, plank or table if you're modifying. This is totally fine as long as, most importantly, it feels good. If it feels wonky on your wrists at all, you can always just plant your hands as you need them. If you do have them in your hands, we want shoulders stacked over elbows, over wrists, knuckles flush with the mat. If you find yourself rolling wrists in, knuckles out, or if it, like I said, if it just feels like too much pressure on your wrists, you can just plant your hands and then just grab the weight to use it as we need it. Cool? Great. We'll get started in child's pose. Friends that have been with me earlier this week know that we have a spicy practice ahead. I think this is everyone's favorite sequence. My new friends, I hope you love it. Just take a moment to drop in here. Give yourself a little check-in. Notice how you're feeling, both physically, mentally, emotionally. Our breath is super important in our Sculpt practice. Helps us to release heat when things get a little spicy. Helps us to fire through the movements when they get challenging, and also helps to keep a yogic mindfulness in the practice ahead. So let's join our breath together. First, exhale, let everything out through your mouth. And take a nice juicy inhale, fill all the way up. Exhale, sigh it out, let everything go. Beautiful, again, fill up, even deeper inhale. Big audible exhale. One last time like that. Deepest inhale of your morning. Forceful exhale out. Really nice. Keep that breath up throughout class. Know that it is always here to serve you, to release heats and help keep you going. As you feel ready, shift forward into a tabletop position and just start to wiggle it out. Take any organic movement that feels good. Friends at home, we will cue up our playlist with the first song, House Arrest, in 3, in 2, in 1, press play. Really good options already. Know that it does not matter what these shapes look like, what options you're taking. It doesn't matter what your neighbor is doing or what you think you should be doing, if you're comfortable doing so, maybe even just close your eyes, listen to your body, see where you need to move, where you need some extra space. Have three full, slow, deep rounds of breath here. So if you're doing anything one-sided, just make sure you balance it out on your second side. Friends, no rush if you are still exploring movement or balancing your sides, but if you feel ready, let's meet in a neutral tabletop position to join together for some cat-cows. Inhale, cow pose. Lift your gaze and your tailbone high. Let your belly soften and melt towards the earth. Exhale, cat. Press firmly into your hands. Drive your spine up to the ceiling and notice the sensation of your shoulder blades pulling apart from one another. We'll reference that a lot. Inhale, cow pose. Lift your gaze. Spread through your collarbones. Exhale, cat. Press and curl. Tuck your chin to your chest. One more round, inhale, cow pose. Exhale, cat, curl it in. Inhale, back through neutral. Tuck your toes if they aren't already and lift your hips up for downward facing dog. Just like in table, feel free to take any movement that feels good. You can pedal it out, sway your hips or heels side to side, shift forward and back. Three rounds of breath to settle in. Nice layers, friends. No rush if you're still exploring, but if you're ready, meet in stillness in your down dog. Spread your fingers out super wide. Feel the webbing between each finger stretch and expand. Bring your index fingers parallel to one another. Micro bend your knees to lift the underside of your seat up farther towards the ceiling, and then let your chest melt towards your thighs. Really nice. Inhale, gaze forward. Lift high on your tippy toes. Take 10 tiny steps to the front of your mat for ragdoll. Feet come wide behind your wrists, maybe all the way out to the edges of your space. Keep a generous bend in your knees and grab opposite elbow, or if there's a different arm grip calling to you, feel free to take it. You can bounce, you can sway, shake your head yes or no. Stay for one more inhale. On your next exhale, release any hand grip you have. Toe heel your feet in so your toes touch. Inhale, halfway lift. Press into your shins or thighs. Lengthen your spine. Reach to the crown of your head. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose. Sweep your arms overhead. Dial your pinkies in towards the back wall. Pull your shoulders down away from your ears and drive your tailbone down towards the earth. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, cactus backbend, goalpost your arms, reach through your heart, squeeze your glutes. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold, hinge from your hips, micro bend your knees. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank and pause. First time here, revisit that feeling of cat pose in your upper spine. Pull your shoulder blades apart, stack your shoulders over your wrists and your heels over your toes. Inhale, shift forward 2 inches, shoulders come past your wrists. Exhale, chaturanga, lower halfway, elbows graze your ribs. Inhale, upward facing dog, hover your thighs. Exhale, down dog, lift your hips up high. Really nice, friends. Know that you can always change up that vinyasa, spice it up, cool it down, skip it all together, do you this morning. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, journey to the top, step hop, maybe float. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, root to rise, mountain pose, sweep it up. This time, grab your left wrist. Exhale, sway to the right, hips go left. Inhale, back through center. Switch your grip. Exhale, sway to the left. Inhale, back through center. Separate your hands. Exhale, cactus back bend, a little bigger this time. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands, step back, and take your vinyasa your own way. Nice options, friends. Way to listen to what you need. One more time through Sun A. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, make your way to the top. Big toes touch. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose. Sweep it up. Grab your left wrist. Exhale, sway to the right. Inhale, back through center. Switch your grip. Exhale, sway to the left. Inhale, back through center. Exhale, cactus back bend. Biggest one yet. Really squeeze your glutes. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands. Step back to plank and pause. First set of frog hops. Bend your knees. Hop forward. Lift your hands. Plant. Hop back. Big exhale every time you lift your hands at the top. We want feet really wide, toes out, heels in, and hips in line with our knees as we lift at the top. If your heels are lifting off the mat, just widen your stance even more. Always an option to step it forward and back one foot at a time. You will work all the same muscles, just taking the jumping impact out of your joints. Nice job, friends. Stick with it for a few more rounds. Let your heart rate start to rise. Just four, three, down dog in two, and one, downward facing dog. Nice work. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, let something go. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, journey to the top, big toes touch. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Sweep your arms overhead. Again, drive your tailbone down so your belly button comes up and in. Pull your shoulders away from your ears. Drive your weight into your heels. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, chair plane. Sweep your hands back. Magnetize your pinkies together as if they could touch. We'll flow it out. Inhale, chair. Exhale, chair plane. Inhale, chair. Exhale, chair plane. One more. Inhale, chair. Exhale, chair plane, and hold. Stay right here or lift your heels for drinking birds. Squeeze your ankles and calves together. Keep it static or pulse your hips down. Pulse. Keep your core tight to help with balance. Wobbles and shakes are okay. Just four. Three. Back to chair in two. And one. Back to chair pose. Sweep your arms overhead. Press your palms together. Bring them through heart center. Toe heel your feet out. Hip width. Basic squat. Bring it down and lift. Inhale. Exhale. Lower and squeeze. Drive your weight into your heels and pull your knees back behind your toes. Squeeze your glutes like crazy at the top to help finalize the engagement. And energetically pull your heels away from one another to fire up the outer line of your legs and your glutes. Big exhale as you lift. Know that you can always slow movements down. I will cue to the beat of the music for fun, but always focus on your alignment more than speed. Just four, three, add a heel lift in two, and one, add a heel lift at the top. Squeeze your calves to help press the tops of your feet towards the mirror. Take it at your own pace. Nice breath. Just four, three, hold your squat low in two, and one, hold your squat low, little pulse, pulse, pulse. Keep your weight in your heels, float your toes. Pulse, pulse. Four, three, two, and one, come to standing. Sweep your left leg behind your right, curtsy setup. Left arm to the sky or right hand to your hip, high on the ball of your left foot. Curtsy lunge, exhale, elbow to knee. Big exhale as you lift. Slow it down if you need to. Land high on the ball mound of your left foot. As your foot leaves the earth, flex your toes towards your shin for a nice, strong, engaged leg. Use your left oblique to pull your knee up higher towards your elbow instead of just curling your elbow down towards your knee. Stick with your breath. Let it drive the movement. Really nice buttery transitions, friends. Just four, three, two, and one. Step your left leg back. Inhale, crescent lunge. Sweep your arms overhead. Lift really high on the ball mound of your left foot. Pull your right hip back, left hip forward, and draw your shoulders away from your ears. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, slice it open, warrior two. Plant your back foot, right toes towards the mirror. Stack your shoulders over your hips. Inhale, flip your front palm. Reverse your warrior. Stay for a round. Feel your right rib cage open. Exhale, windmill your hands down. Hands come wide. Sit back to plank. Wide arm push-up. Bring it down and up. Lower. Lift. Inhale. Exhale. These can be done from your knees or your toes. Down. Press. Lower. Lift. We want hands wider than mat width, so our elbows stack over our wrists at the bottom. Keep your core tight and hips in one even plane with your shoulders. Y'all are crushing it. Push-ups are hard. Stick with it for four. Three. Pulse it low in two. Little pulse. 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 Tiny movements. 1 inch up, 1 inch down. You got it. Pulse. Just four. Three. Two. And one. Downward facing dog. Lift your hips to the sky. Nice work, friends. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, journey to the top. Big toes touch. Inhale, chair pose. Sink your seat down and back. Weight in your heels. Bring your palms through center. Toe heel your feet out. Hip width. Back to our basic squat. Lower. Lift. Inhale. Exhale. Down and squeeze. Again, pull your knees back. Drag your heels away from one another without actually letting them move. Just four. Three. We'll add a hop at the top in two. And one, add a little hop at the top. If this does not feel good on your knees, come back to your heel lift or stick with your basic squat. If you're adding the hop, land with bent knees. Use an exhale to help drive you up. You got this. Stick with it. Just a few more sets. Just four. Three. Hold your squat low in two. And one. Hold your squat low. Pulse it. Left. Center. Right. Center. Left. Center, right, center. Stay as low as you can. Left, center, right, center. Just four, three, two, and one. Swing your right leg behind your left. Curtsy set up other side. Right arm to the sky. Curtsy. Elbow to knee crunch. And big exhale to help you lift it up. Use your right oblique. Lift your knee 1 inch higher. Keep your shoulders stacked over your hips the entire time. Nice job, friends. This is meant to challenge you. Just four. Three. Crescent in two, and one. Step your right leg back. Inhale, crescent lunge. Pull your shoulders down, left hip back, right hip forward. Inhale to lengthen your spine. Exhale, slice it open, warrior two to the front. Gaze over your left fingertips. Inhale, flip your front palm, reverse your warrior, stay for a round. Exhale, windmill your hands down. Hands come wide, last set, wide arm push-ups, you got it. Lower. Lift, down, press, inhale, exhale. Again, toes or knees. Tight core the entire time. You are almost there. Stick with me. Just four, three. Hold it low in two, and one. Just hold it low. Static hold. Hold. Hold, you got it. Breathe. Woo! Just four, three, two, and one. Downward facing dog. Hi, yi, yi. Amazing work, my friends. Woo! Take a breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale your right leg up to the sky. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Grab your light set of weights. Lift your torso. All right. Hinge your torso forward. One long line of energy from your heel to the crown of your head. Arms straight, palms face your body. It's wide row. Extend, bend, release. Row, extend, bend, release. Row, straighten, bend, release. Lift, open, close, and lower. Now and in any movement, if the fatigue is setting in, you can always alternate one arm at a time to give one arm a break in between rounds. Really use your triceps to help extend your arms out straight to the side. Lift, extend, bend, release. Just four, three, hold your arms out straight in two, and one, hold your arms out straight, pulse it back, back, back. Four, three, two, and one, bring it through center, inhale, crescent lunge, press your weights straight up. Exhale, weights through center, open up, warrior two, little W in your arms, heads of your weights up, light grip on the weight. Inhale, reverse your warrior, right weight straight up, no leaning back. Exhale, weights through center, pivot, plant, step back to plank, frog hop with the hammer curl. Hop it forward like we did before. Take a hammer curl at the top, plant and back. Still, you have the option to step it forward and back one foot at a time. Option to ditch the weights. Take it fast or slow. Big exhale at the top. Keep your feet wide as you land in your frog squat. Just four, three, down dog in two, and one, downward facing dog. Nice work, friends. Inhale your left leg up to the sky. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Grab your light weights if you drop them. Lift your torso. Hinge it forward, arms straight, palms face your body. Same movement, other side. Row, extend, bend, release. Up, open, close, and down. Lift, extend, bend, release. Keep your torso hinged forward to help protect your spine and keep it nice and long. Stick with your breath. Nice work, friends. This is a challenging first weighted movement, but y'all are crushing. Just four, three, hold your elbows at 90 in two, and one, hold your elbows at 90, pulse them back, back, back. Squeeze your shoulder blades together to do so. Pulse, 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 pulse. Just four, three, two, and one. Bring it through center. Press it up. Crescent lunge. Exhale, weights through center. Open up. Warrior two. Little W in your arm. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, pull through center. Pivot. Plant. Step it back. Last set. Frog hop with the hammer curl at the top. Take whatever layer you need. Steps, hops, fast, slow, weights, no weights. Nice work, friends. Good job, Teresa. Just four, three, down dog in two, and one, downward facing dog. Drop down to your knees. Grab a little sip of water if you want it. Friends who are new, this isn't like always normal, what we're about to do, but it's fun. It's spicy, it's fun. We're gonna do a circuit. So three movements. Three rounds for each movement. First round, each move is a minute. Second round, each movement is 45 seconds. Third round, each move is 30 seconds. So it gets progressively easier as time goes on. Come to standing when you're ready. Grab your light or heavy set of weights. I will leave it up to you. know that you can always change it up if you want more or less as we get going. All right, first movement, feet hip width, weights to your shoulders. It's squat, uppercut, just alternating side to side. Make sure you pivot on your back toes as you punch. Turn your chest and hips the direction of your punch. This will protect your knee joint as you pivot. As you punch, really drive your weight forward and back. We don't want willy-nilly swinging. Focus on your squat alignment in between. You can take this as slow as you want. Stick with your breath. You are more than halfway there. Nice job, friends. 10 seconds. Just four. Stick with me for three, two, and one. Stand at the top. Press your weights up, down, hop it back forward. Weighted burpees. Option to go back to the frog hops. Option to ditch your weights altogether. Do a traditional burpee. Option to step it forward and back. The whole point of this circuit is to continue to push you till you don't want to go anymore. And then keep going anyway and prove to yourself that you can. Just keep breathing. Modify if you need to. Slow it down if you need to. Just 15 seconds. You can do anything that long. Just four. Three. Meet in your plank in two. And one. Step back to your plank. Keep your weights from knees or from toes. It's row, release, alternating narrow row. Keep your arm tight in by your rib cage. If you're down on your knees, same thing. Whether you're on toes or knees, keep them wide, knees wide, toes wide. This will help stabilize your hips as you lift one weight off the earth. Big exhale every time you row it up. You're almost done with your longest set. Nice form, Bridget. Just four. Three. Stick with me for two. And one. Step or hop forward. Come to standing. Grab your weights. Round two. Squat. Uppercut. Squat. Uppercut. Squat. Uppercut. Squat. And uppercut. Again, slow it down if you need to. It does not have to be fast. Never sacrifice form for speed. Drive your weight in your heels in the squat. Pull your knees back. Weights or no weights, lights or heavies. You do you. 15 seconds. Again, pivot on your back toe as you punch. Just four, three, back to our burpees in two, and one, press your weights up, down, hop it back, and forward. Nice job, keep breathing. I know the fatigue is setting in, but you are getting stronger mentally and physically. Ten seconds. Just four. Three. Back to your plank in two. And one. Knees or toes. Row. Release. Row. Release. Pull it up. Down. Lift. Lower. Exhale, inhale. Keep pushing, friends. Last set coming up, shortest one. Just four, three, two, and one. Step or hop to the top. Come to standing. Weights come to your shoulders. All right, 30 seconds each round. That's only a minute and a half total. You got this. All right, first move, squat, uppercut, squat, uppercut, lower, and punch, lower, punch. Sink your seat low. Focus on your form. Keep breathing. Just four, three, burpees in two, and one. Back to your burpees. Press it up, down, hop it back and forward. Weights or no weights, just keep going. Don't give up now. Ten seconds, that's it. One more move after this. Just four, three, meet in your plank in two. And one, meet in your plank. Row, release, up, down, lift, lower. Feet or knees wide, stabilize your hips. Keep breathing, keep pushing, 15 seconds. Yes, you can. Just four, three, two, and one. Whew. Really, really good work, friends. Take a sip of water. Towel off if you need. We're going to get right back in it because this class is only an hour and I never have enough time. Whew. When you're ready, let's meet in downward facing dog. All right, friends, take a deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale your right leg to the sky. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Grab your heavy set of weights, lift your torso. Fun. Press your weights together at heart center. Pull your shoulders back, elbows wide. Lunge, twist, center, lift. Lunge, twist, center, and lift. If you want to spice it up more, add a knee drive at the top. Lunge, twist, center, knee drive. If you want even more spikes than that, add a full kick. Lunge, twist, center, and kick. Keep your weights glued at heart center. Make the twist come from your obliques. Don't just drive your elbow back. That will mean a smaller twist, but a more effective, engaged one. Nice job, Sabina. Just four, three, curtsy set up in two, and one. Step your left leg behind your right, arm straight, palms forward. Curtsy, bicep curl, curtsy and curl. Lower, lift. Again, shoulders down and back. Slow it down if you need to. It can be much slower than the beat of the music. Stay high on the ball mound of your left foot. Think super high stiletto heel. Big exhale as you lift. Y'all are crushing it. These are all big muscle groups. You got it. Just four, three. Hold your curtsy low in two. And one, hold your curtsy low, elbows to 90, pulse it up. Pulse. Pulse. One inch up, one inch down with your weights. Shoulders back, chest proud. Pulse. 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 Just four, three, two, and one. Step to the top of your space. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Sorry, Travis. Topple your weights on and toe heel your feet out wide. Toes out, heels in, frog squats. Down, lift, lower, and press. Inhale. Exhale, straight arms the entire time. Just bend your knees to lower and lift your hips. You'll almost never hear me say this, but actually lock out your elbows so they don't bend at all. Down and press. Awesome adjustments, friends. Down and lift. Lower. Squeeze. Inhale. Exhale. flat spine. Only lower your hips as low as your knees. That's where the fire is. Down, press, lower, lift. Inhale, exhale, just four, three. Pulse your hips low in two. Little pulse, 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 pulse. Woo, pulse. It's supposed to feel the way it feels, I promise. Pulse, 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 pulse. Just four, three, two, and one. Ditch your weight, step back, downward facing dog. Woo-wee. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale your left leg up to the sky. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Grab your heavy set of weights or whatever you used on the other side. Lift your torso, weights at heart center. Lunge, twist, center, and lift. Lunge, twist, center, lift. Lower, twist, center, maybe knee drive. Down, twist, center, or a kick. Big exhale every time you twist and every time you lift, knee drive or kick. If you are knee driving or kicking, flex your right foot like crazy, toes towards your shin. Engage your leg as much as humanly possible. Really great control, Peggy. Almost there. Stick with it. Make the twist come from your obliques. Nice intensity, Julie. Just four. Three. Curtsy set up in two. And one. Sweep your right leg back. This time, palms out wide. Curtsy, wide curl. Lower. Curl. Inhale. Exhale. Keep your core tight. Stack your shoulders over your hips. Stack your heel over your toes. Down, curl, lower, and lift. Guess what? We get to take a break from our weights soon. Is that good news or not? Lower and lift. Just four, three. Hold it low in two. And one. Hold it low. Elbows to 90. Serve it out. Out. Woo! Just four, three, two, and one. Step to the top. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Topple your weights. Toe heel your feet out wide. Back to our frog squats. Down and press. Lower, lift. Inhale. Exhale again. Super straight arms. Light grip on your weights. Make your core support you. Down. Press. Inhale, exhale. Flat spine, gaze just in front of your mat to keep your cervical spine long. Lower and press. Inhale, exhale, down and squeeze. Almost there. Just four, three. Pulse your hips low in two. Pulse it low. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Whoo! Pulse, pulse. I am right here with you. I feel it too. Pulse, pulse. Whoo! Keep breathing. Just four, three, two, and one. Release. Shake it out. Ditch your weights. Grab a sip of water if you want it. Take small sips, so we're about to get the party going. Friends at home, I hope you're breathing as heavily as me. I will skip forward two songs to smash it up. All right, my darlings, time for some cardio. If you're ready, start to kick your butt. If you need a break during cardio, no big deal. Please take it if you need it. Just sidestep it out. Keep some sort of gentle movement happening in your body. We don't want to stop cold turkey while our heart rates are so high. Start to make your way to the top of your mat. Just four, three, football runners in two, and one, get low. Swing your arms, light on your feet. Let everything jiggle and shake. As you're ready, start to football run it back. High knees forward. Football run back. High knees forward. Just four, three, surfer squats in two, and one, swap it right, center, left, center. If you need less, take a basic squat. If you need more, skip the center hop. Just four, three, face knee in two, and one, jack it out. Woo! You got this, keep breathing. Just four, three, skaters in two, and one, skaters. Opposite hand, opposite foot. Take it slow like a step to catch your breath, or fast like a skip to keep it rolling. Just four, three, Smurf jacks in two, and one, get low. Option two, step it out one side at a time. Just four, three, face knee in two, and one, ballet hops. Cross the opposite ankle in front, option for hands to hips, option to tap it out. Almost there, stick with me. Keep going, you are so close. Just four, three, two, and one. Holy heck, great job, friends. Start two sides, step it out right away. Again, we want to keep gentle movement in our body while our heart rate's raging. Start to intentionally slow and deepen your breath to help bring your heart rate down. I'll bring some fresh air in. If you're ready, have the arms overhead on an inhale. Exhale, let it go. So friends, give yourself a few more rounds of breath to bring it back down. Just four, three, two, and one. Feet hip width, active recovery, hands heart center, slowest squat of your life. Bring it down with control. Bring it back up with just as much smooth, buttery transition. Squeeze your glutes at the top. Now that we are moving so fast, really focus on your form. Float your toes, drive your weight into your heels. Squeeze your heels away from one another, even more than you think. Pull your knees back at the bottom. Just four, three, two, and one. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands. Take your flow if you want it, or straight to down dog. All right, really good work, friends. One super short flow. And then we get to cool it down. Inhale your right leg up to the sky. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Grab your light set of weights, lift your torso. Elbows to 90 and a goal post, everyone's favorite position to be in. Lunge, shoulder press, lunge and press. Down, Lift gently, tap your weights together at the top to keep control. Be stubborn about stopping at 90 degrees at the bottom. For your lunge, stack your right knee over your ankle, left knee beneath your hip. And again, a super high stiletto foot on your left. Keep your core tight. Option to drop your back knee and just focus on your upper arm if your lower body's fatigued. Lower and press. Just 4, 3. Hold it low in 2. And one, hold your lunge low, alternating punch, punch, punch. Just 4, 3, 2, and 1. Straighten your back leg, elbows to 90. Hinge your torso forward, tricep kick, and bend. Exhale, inhale, press, release. If you want more spice, add another lunge as you bend your elbows. If you want even more spice than that, add a back kick as you extend. Nice job, Rebecca. Almost there. Just 4, 3. Pulse your weights back in 2. Pulse them back, back. Really squeeze your triceps. Lift your weights higher. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Just 4, 3, 2. And 1, inhale, crescent. Exhale, bring your weights to the mat. Step it back. Ditch your weights, I lied. Set up for plank. Shoulder tap, knee tap, knee tap. Shoulder tap, knee tap, knee tap. Keep your feet wide to help stabilize your hips. If you want to take this from your knees, you could just focus on the shoulder taps. Great option, take what you need. Just 4, 3, down dog in 2, and 1, downward facing dog. All right, one more side, just those couple movements. You got this. Inhale your left leg up to the sky. Exhale, low lunge, bring it through. Grab your light set of weights again. Lift your torso, elbows to 90, slight change. This time it is lunge, lat pull. Lunge, pull, lower and squeeze. Inhale, exhale. Check your left knee, make sure it's not going beyond your ankle or beyond your toes. Really use your back muscles to pull your elbows together behind you. Big exhale every time you squeeze it in and up. Y'all are crushing this. I know it's hard, that's the point. Just 4, 3, hold it low in 2, and 1, elbows at 90, back to our punch, 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 woo, punch, punch. Just 4, 3, 2, and 1, straighten your back leg, hinge your torso forward. This time, it's palms up and in, tricep kick and bend. Exhale, inhale, press, release. If you did so before, add the lunge as you bend your elbows, or add the back kick as you extend. Use your triceps. Take momentum out of the equation. Make your muscles do the work to press your weights past your hips. Get it, Travis. Just 4, 3. Hold your weights high in 2. And 1, hold your weights high, pulse them in, squeeze. Just 4, 3, 2, and 1. Holy, inhale, crescent. Exhale, fold, ditch your weights, step back to plank. One last spicy move, it's 3 mountain climbers. Hold it in, shoulder tap, shoulder tap. 3 mountain climbers, other knee will be in, shoulder tap, shoulder tap. Tap, tap, pull, 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 tap, 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 10 seconds. You got it. Just 4, 3, down dog in 2, and 1, downward facing dog. All right, you made it through the worst of it, just a little core. Then we'll stretch it out, drop down to your knees, swing your legs around. Okay, if you were with me all week, I promise we won't see these again for a while, but full set crow crunches. Lay flat on your back, bend your knees, bend your elbows, flex your feet, flex your wrists. Exhale, knee to elbow, think crow pose on your back. Inhale, tap your heels and your fingertips down. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, tap. Pull and tap. Drive your low spine into the mat the entire time, especially as you tap your heels and fingers. It has a tendency to pop up. Nice form, Nick. Just 4, 3. Hold your crow crunch in 2, and 1. Hold everything in. Keep your left side in. Extend your right arm and leg. Exhale, pull it in. Extend and pull. Inhale. Exhale. Lengthen and squeeze. Open. Close. Inhale. Exhale. Just 4, 3. Hold your right side out long in 2, and 1. Hold it out long. Pulse your toes up. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Keep going. Pulse. Just 4, 3, 2, 1. Other side. Back to full range. Crunch it up and tap. Exhale. Inhale. Squeeze. Tap. Pull. Release. Just 4, 3. Hold it in 2, and 1. Hold it in. Keep your right side intact. Extend your left. Pull it in. Extend. Pull. Extend. Squeeze. Inhale. Exhale. Keep going. You got this. Extend. Pull. Just 4, 3, hold it out in 2, and 1, hold your left side out, pulse your toes up, pulse, pulse, final push, don't give up on yourself now, pulse, pulse, just 4, 3, keep going for 2, and 1, release, oh boy, full body stretch, hoo-wee. Everyone close your eyes so I can turn the lights off without them turning on accident. All right. Friends at home, we're going to skip forward to Sad Boy. Before we start to stretch, just give yourself a quick moment of like really intense, serious gratitude. This is a hard class always. It's an especially spicy sequence. And somehow it's way harder at 5:45 in the morning. So give yourself credit for all the work you just put in. If you're ready, pull your knees into center. Turn yourself into a little ball. Feel free to rock side to side, forward and back, whatever feels good along your spine. So as you're ready, we'll take figure 4. Cross your right ankle over your left thigh. Flex both feet. Stay right here or interlace your hands behind your left hamstring, pulling your legs up towards your chest. Again, you can rock or sway here if that feels good, or just melt in stillness in the stretch. Stay for one more inhale. Your exhale, keep the crest of your legs, but let them fall to the left. Plant the sole of your right foot on the earth. Arms come out to a T or a goalpost and gaze over your right shoulder. If there's a different leg variation for a supine twist that you would prefer, please take it. If you like the figure 4 but want more hip intensity within your twist, grab your right ankle, the planted one, with your left hand and pull it up closer towards your face. Breathe super deeply here. Over-exaggerate your breath. Balloon out your belly to create compression. On every exhale, let everything ring out and soften. Two more rounds of breath. Your next exhale, bring your knees back in through center. Happy baby between sides. Bend your knees. Grab the inner or outer edges of your feet or your ankles, behind your calves, behind your hamstrings, wherever your hands make contact is perfectly fine. Just make sure you can drive your sacrum, your low spine, down into the earth. You can rock or sway, straddle one leg, then the other or both to get into your hamstrings. In your next exhale, release figure four, other side, cross your left ankle over your right thigh. Then match the intensity of the stretch you got on the other side. Your feet can stay planted or interlace your hands behind your right hamstring, pulling your legs in towards your body. Again, you can rock or sway or just enjoy stillness here. Stay for one more inhale. The next exhale, keep the cross of your legs. Let them fall towards me. Plant the sole of your left foot on the earth. Arms go out to a T or a goalpost. Gaze over your left shoulder towards the mural. Again, if there's a different leg variation you would like in your twist, please take it. If you want more intensity in your hip and you have the figure four, grab your left ankle with your right hand. Pull your foot up closer towards your face. And we're not here super long, so make the breath count. Really deep inhales, really thorough exhales. One more round of breath here. On your next exhale, pull your knees in towards center and cross your legs. Turn yourself into a tiny little ball. Hug your shins, curl your forehead towards your knees. Squeeze every muscle that you just worked so hard. And then release final Shavasana. Arms and legs come out wide, palms face up. Allow yourself to take up space. And just melt into a little sculpt puddle. Is where the work really pays off, when we get to integrate everything that just happened into our bodies, integrate it into our minds. And I will let you know when it's time to come back. So just be here now and relax. Friends, if any part of you wants to stay here longer, please do so. If your morning is calling you, start small by wiggling your fingers and your toes. movement grow and expand through your ankles and your wrists. And on an inhale, sweep your arms overhead for a full body stretch. On an exhale, roll to one side or the other using your bicep as a pillow. And however feels natural to you, come to a comfortable seated position with your eyes closed or your gaze soft and your hands at heart center. Thank you guys so much for showing up to put in this work. Every time you do this practice, the obvious thought is that you're getting stronger physically. While that is a nice side effect, the real practice is how much we're strengthening our minds. As I mentioned at the beginning of class, every time you want to give up and you keep pushing and keep moving forward, you're conditioning yourself to know that you can. When things get hard in life off of our mats, we can use these skills we've cultivated to keep pushing and keep going. So thank you so much for putting in that work to make not only yourself stronger, but your families and your community around you. I see, love, and appreciate each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart. So you're ready, shift your thumbs to your third eye. In gratitude, we bow. Namaste. Okay, I'm glad we're done with that week's class. So next time it will be something different. That's a spicy one. So for real, amazing work. Weights can go on the silver rack by where you picked up your weights, so I can sanitize them in between. What else? 300-hour YTT is coming up. Now, even if you are not interested in taking a 300-hour teacher training, don't have your 200-hour, anything like that, it's all offered in modules. So basically just all a bunch of different workshops that the trainees can choose from, but anyone can take them without doing the full training. There's a wide variety of things that are spicy, like sculpt, power training, acro yoga, but also things like Ayurveda, Kirtan and chanting, a lot of softer practices as well. So if you are looking to explore different varieties of the yoga practice, please check that out on our workshops tab. But I will be out front if you have any questions, thoughts, or feedback. Thanks, guys.